led by Dr. Joe James of Chestnut Return Farm in Oconee County, Clemson University graduate instructor Adam Coates and 22 of his forestry students visited a sprawling upstate research center to learn about the latest scientific findings on the restoration of the American chestnut in southern climes.
I often get asked, why do I feel so passionate about the American chestnut tree? And it is a lot of work. It has been a really long-term project, and it seems to almost have no end, but I can see the light at the end of the tunnel at this point. And we've been through more getting here than we have to go to the end. And the main reason I think that the American chestnut is so important is from ecological point of view that I have deep feelings about. Feeding the wildlife, everything eats chestnuts, including human beings. And the Indians subsisted on chestnuts during the wintertime, and chinkapins and other nuts a little bit. But primarily, they got a lot of chestnuts to get them through the winter. And it saved a lot of Indian lives, I'm sure, over the years. So it is a big hole in our ecological food chain to have no more chestnuts.
I think the most important thing to understand is the process and the elements of success, the elements of failure, but that all along the way, you're building one layer at a time towards understanding not only about chestnut blight, but about Phytophthora, about the genetics of chestnut, and its importance in the environment.
What impressed me the most about this was just seeing the work that is going into restoring the American chestnut and learning a little more about the process of how we might get there someday. I was very interested in the American chestnut coming into this, and I've heard a lot of stories from my grandparents about actually seeing them and about the value that they did have in the ecosystem. So one day I would like to see the chestnut as they did and to actually understand and be able to actually see that ecological niche field someday, and this is a hope that that might happen. So along with more work and all of the scientific data that we're collecting right now, hopefully someday we can see that.